हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संतोष काळे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग माळेगाव बीके बारामती। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस लैपलास ट्रांसफॉर्म। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आर द लिमिटेशंस ऑफ फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म एंड व्हाई देर इज अ नीड ऑफ लैपलास ट्रांसफॉर्म। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी द लिमिटेशन ऑफ फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म। The most important limitation of Fourier transform is that there are many functions for which Fourier transform does not exist. This is because such a functions are not absolutely integrable. And the second, we know that it is difficult to calculate the convolution and then to obtain the system response by using the Fourier transform. The differential equation with initial conditions cannot be solved by using Fourier transform. As well as the stability and pole zero behavior cannot be studied using the Fourier transform. So these are the limitations of Fourier transform. That's why there is a need of Laplace transform. So Laplace transform can reduce the problem of solving differential equation to an algebraic problem. So the solution of differential equation becomes simple by using Laplace transform. Many mechanical and electrical forces are discontinuous in nature or may be present only for short amount of time period. So these forces are not sine or cosine functions. That means solution of these functions become very difficult. So Laplace transform can convert such a type of functions into sine and cosine function, so the solution become simple. Both complementary and particular solution can be obtained in one operation using Laplace transform. So it can give the complete solution of differential equation. So this is all about the need of Laplace transform. Now let us see the formula for Laplace transform. So Laplace of f of t, this is equal to f of s, and this is equal to integration from 0 to infinity f of t into e raised to minus st into dt. Next, the formula of inverse Laplace transform. So Laplace inverse of f of s, this is equal to f of t, this is equal to 1 upon 2 pi j integration sigma minus j infinity to sigma plus j infinity f of s into e raised to st into ds. Next, let us see some example based on Laplace transform. Let us find out the Laplace transform of unit step signal. So Laplace of e of t, this is equal to, first of all you have to put the value of e of t in the formula of Laplace transform. This is unit step signal, therefore it is present from 0 to infinity. So you can set the limit of integration from 0 to infinity. For this range, value of unit step signal is 1 into e raised to minus st into dt. Perform the integration. So you can get e raised to minus st upon s. The minus sign is outside. And apply these values 0 to infinity. So finally you can get answer 1 upon s. Therefore, Laplace transform of unit step signal is 1 upon s. Now let us find out the Laplace transform of a unit impulse. So this is the graphical look of del of t minus t0. Mathematically, we can express del of t minus t0, this is equal to 0 for t is not equal to 0. And we know that integration t0 minus epsilon to t0 plus epsilon del of t minus t0 into dt, this is equal to 1 for epsilon greater than 0. So if you apply the Laplace transform of delta signal, so first of all you have to write the formula of Laplace transform. That is integration from 0 to infinity del of t into e raised to minus st into dt. So del of t having the value, if you put the value 0 in the place of t, you can get a raised to minus 0 s and this is equal to 1. Therefore the Laplace of delta signal, it is 1. So we have an important point to remember, that is if you apply the Laplace transform on f of t, we can get f of s, so which can represent a Fourier transform here. Now let us see another example, Laplace of e raised to minus at into unit step signal. So you first of all write the formula, integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus at into e raised to minus st into dt, unit step signal having the value 1, therefore 1 is the multiplier for this. Now integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus s plus a into t into dt. So solve this integration. After solving the integration, you can get minus e raised to minus st upon s plus a, and the limits are from 0 to infinity. Putting this value, you can get 1 upon s plus a. This is the final answer, Laplace of e raised to minus at into u of t. Now let us consider the time shifted signals. Let us find out the Laplace of f of t minus a into e of t minus a. This is equal to integration a to infinity f of t minus a into e raised to minus st. Now let us consider x equal to t minus a, then dx equal to dt and t equal to x plus a. As t tends to a, x tends to 0, and as t tends to infinity, x tends to infinity. So integration 0 to infinity f of x into a raised to minus x plus a, by putting the value of x equal to t minus a, you can write this equation, and finally we can get e raised to minus as into integration 0 to infinity f of x into e raised to minus sx into dx. So finally we have the answer. We know that e raised to minus as into, this is the formula of Laplace, so you can write e raised to minus as into f of s. This is the final answer, Laplace of time shifted signals. Now let us find out the Laplace of frequency shifted signal, Laplace of e raised to minus at into f of t. Once again you have to write the formula, integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus at into f of t into e raised to minus st into dt. So arranging the terms, you can get integration 0 to infinity as it is, f of t as it is, e raised to minus at into e raised to minus st can be written in this way into dt, and this is equal to f of s plus a. So finally Laplace of e raised to minus at into f of t, this is equal to f of s plus a. This is all about the frequency shifted signals. Now there are some transform pairs, Laplace of del of t, this is equal to 1, Laplace of unit step signal 1 upon s, Laplace of e raised to minus st is 1 upon s plus a, Laplace of t answer is 1 upon s square, and Laplace of t raised to n, this is equal to n factorial upon s raised to n plus 1. So these are the some of the standard transform pairs related to Laplace transform. Now let us consider t, it is multiplied with e raised to minus at, and if you obtain the Laplace transform, you can get the answer 1 upon s plus a bracket square, t raised to n into e raised to minus at. Apply the Laplace transform on it, you can get n factorial upon s plus a raised to n plus 1. Laplace of sine omega t, this is equal to omega upon s square plus omega square, or cos omega t, this is equal to answer is s upon s square plus omega square. Now let us see some another terms, e raised to minus at into sine wt or omega t, this is equal to w upon s plus a bracket square plus w square. Laplace of e raised to minus at into cos wt, this is equal to s plus a upon s plus a bracket square plus w square. Sine of wt plus theta, obtain the Laplace, you can get the answer s into sine theta plus w into cos theta upon s square plus w square. Similarly, Laplace of cos wt plus theta, answer is s into cos theta minus w into sine theta upon s square plus w square. So this is all about the disadvantages of Fourier transform, need of Laplace, definition of Laplace transform, some of the formulas related to Laplace transform. In the next screencast, we will see the properties of Laplace transform. Thank you very much.